لكل سائل سبحانه هو التائب على من تاب فلم يجعل بينه وبين العباد حائل سبحانه جعل ما على الأرض زينة لها وكل نعيم لا محالة زائل سبحانه حذر الناس من الشيطان وللشيطان منافذ وحدائق فمن أسلم وجهه لله فذلك الكيس العاقل ومن استسلم لهواه فذلك الضال الغافل نحمده تبارك وتعالى على كل حال وواقع ونسأله أن يحفظ علينا العقول والأبصار والمسامع وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد أحبتي في الله تعالى حياكم الله وبياكم وأبقاكم عوامل رفع لهذه الأمة وحياكم وأسأل الله أن يبارك جمعنا هذا وأن يجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the master of the whole universe. He is the creator, the charger, the sustainer, the provider, the one who protects us from any harm. I bear witness openly that there is no God but Allah. I bear witness openly that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger of Allah. We are sending our blessings and our salutations to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to all the messengers, the prophets of Allah, and also to the entire companion and the entire household of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Dear respected brothers and sisters, welcome back to another opportunity to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His masjid. Welcome back to another opportunity to witness another Jumu'ah. And when it comes to the blessings of Jumu'ah, they are many. And when it comes to the witness of Jumu'ah, it is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives us another chance so we can witness Jumu'ah and we can attend Jumu'ah, gather together for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, although the pandemic that we have, although the trials, the tribulations, the hard times that we have, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all together for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to seek the knowledge and to come close to the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters in Islam, of course, when it comes to these period of time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed us in the Quran to keep reciting and not only to gain the hasanat or the blessings of Allah or to gain the reward in our records or in our scale by the day of judgment, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to take the reflection from the Quran and to understand and to realize the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us in the Quran. And of course, when it comes to the Quran, we have been commanded in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and in the Quran not to only to recite but to understand and to implement and to act in accordance with the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And one of the issues that I wanted to share with everyone, the surah that we are reciting the most, the surah that we are reciting every Jumu'ah and every night of Jumu'ah, it has many of the blessings. It has lots of virtues. And inshallah, not only in one Jumu'ah, but in the chains, in many Jumu'ahs, inshallah, we are going to talk about the virtues and the benefits that we can take from Surah Al-Kahf. Surah Al-Kahf, that is very profound, very remarkable surah, especially when it comes to the crisis, especially when it comes to the tribulations. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, Surah Al-Kahf, as we know, almost in the middle of the Quran. That is why it is the center of the Quran. Even the scholars, when they started to count the Quran word by word, they reached to that word which equals or which comes at the middle of the Quran exactly by words, which is وَلْيَتَلَطَّفْ. And that word in Surah Al-Kahf, وَلْيَتَلَطَّفْ, means to be kind, to be merciful, and to be good to others. So this is the middle of the Quran by words. When it comes to Surah Al-Kahf, it was from the early revelation. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari that he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَإِنَّ مِنَ السِّوَرِ السُّوَرِ الْعِتَابِ. Al-Itaab means the early revelation. Maryam, Taha, and Al-Kahf. So the early revelation, Surah Al-Kahf, was at the beginning of Islam. And why it is so, you know, remarkable, why it is so special in Islam, Surah Al-Kahf? Surah Al-Kahf, it has many themes. But the main theme for Surah Al-Kahf is the protection of Allah from any trials, from any tribulation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us the message through Surah Al-Kahf that He is there to protect us. And how many tribulations we have in our life? We have many. But the Surah Al-Kahf asserted the point of the tribulations of four things. Number one, the tribulation of religion is to be persecuted because you are worshipping Allah. And that is why we have the story of the young men, the story of the people of the cave. That is why they struggled for their religion and they had the test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah saved them. That's number one. The story number one. Number two, it has the story of the man of the two gardens. And it is another tribulation, another test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the test of money, the test of wealth. Number three, it has the third story about the tribulation of the power. The tribulation of the power, the authority. When it comes to the story of the Dhulqarnayn, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him power. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him with the authority and he didn't disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number four, it is the tribulation and the story of knowledge. The tribulation and the test of knowledge through the Prophet Musa alayhi salam. Allah tested him with the knowledge. Allah tested him to learn from somebody. He is not a prophet. He is not a messenger, but he tried to give the knowledge upon him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to give us the message, no matter what you have, even if you have power, even if you have wealth, even if you have knowledge, don't, even if you are pious, even if you are a religious person, don't get arrogant. Don't feel arrogant with your knowledge or with your wealth or with your authority. These are the main ideas for Surah Al-Kahf. But let me share with you something very important about the virtue of Surah Al-Kahf, because we have lots of people are neglecting reciting Surah Al-Kahf. And that is something, wallahi, we need to realize it has lots of benefits. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned in that hadith, it is mentioned in Sahih Muslim that whoever memorized the first 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf, Allah is going to protect him from the tribulations of Dajjal. And that is something very important. We have another very long hadith, but I will get to my point in this hadith. When the Sahaba started to talk about Ad-Dajjal and the tribulation of Dajjal, and they started to feel scary, they said, we thought that if we open the door, that we are going to find the Dajjal in front of us. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came back and he entered and he said, what's going on? What happened? They said, Ya Rasulullah, we remember Ad-Dajjal. We remember the hadith, the stories of Ad-Dajjal. And we felt scared. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if Ad-Dajjal came while me amongst you, I'm going to protect you from Ad-Dajjal. But if Ad-Dajjal came after me, so everyone should protect himself. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, how we are going to protect ourselves from Ad-Dajjal? He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, very long hadith to prescribe Ad-Dajjal, to talk about Ad-Dajjal, to describe his fitna, his tribulation. But he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in this hadith, let anyone face Ad-Dajjal or come close to Ad-Dajjal, let him recite the first 10 verses in Surah Al-Kahf. That is why it is so important. And not only this, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever recites Surah Al-Kahf every Jumu'ah, it will give him the light from his Jumu'ah to the next Jumu'ah. Anyone recites Surah Al-Kahf, all his minor sins will be forgiven between the two Jumu'ahs. Whoever recites Surah Al-Kahf, it will intercede for him by the Day of Judgment. It will talk on behalf of him to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive his sins by the Day of Judgment. That is why Surah Al-Kahf is very important in our life. And not only this, let me tell you the reason why Allah revealed Surah Al-Kahf. What is the reason behind the revelation of Surah Al-Kahf? And as we mentioned, it was from the surah which has revealed at the early days of Islam, the early revelation. And what is the reason for that? Some of the disbelievers of Mecca came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the people of Mecca weren't aware of that term. What does it mean to be a prophet? What does it mean to be a messenger? They didn't experience this before. They didn't know what does it mean to be a prophet. That is why they felt doubt in the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they sent some of them, actually three of them, to Al-Medina to meet the Jewish community, and to meet the Jews in Al-Medina, in Yathrib. And they went to them and they said, we have a person who is claiming that he is a prophet who came with the message, who came with something called Quran. How we can test him? How we can quiz him? Or how can we know that he is actually a prophet? So the scholars of the Jewish community in Medina said to them, if you wanted to be sure if he is a prophet or not, ask him three questions. Test him. The three questions, he has to answer two of them, and one of them he cannot answer. So that was the challenge. How to quiz the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu That is why they went to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the three questions. They said, "Oh Muhammad, if you're really a prophet, tell us about the young men who struggled for their religion. And number two, tell us about the man who started to bring peace to the East and the West. And the third question, tell us about Ar-Ruh, about the soul." Then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Imam Ibn Kathir mentioned in his tafsir, that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Okay, I will tell you the answer tomorrow." And he didn't say, he forgot to say, "Insha'Allah." Then the revelation delayed, didn't come at that time. That is why when you recite Surah Al-Kahf, Allah is talking to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in that way when he said to him, وَلَا تَقُولَنَّ لِشَيْءٍ إِنِّي فَاعِلٌ ذَلِكَ وَدَا إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ. Do not say about anything that I'm going to do that tomorrow except by the willing of Allah, except by the will of Allah, by the destiny of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Means, oh Muhammad, you should say, "Insha'Allah." That is the direction to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the revelation came, not only with Surah Al-Kahf, but Surah Al-Isra, which was what we call it, Surah Bani Israel, or Surah Al-Isra and Surah Al-Kahf. Allah is answering the three questions. It demonstrates the three questions that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had been asked before or by the people of Yathrib or the Jewish community. So the first two questions is the story of the people of Al-Kahf and the story of the Dhul-Qarnayn. And the third question about the soul, the answer came in Surah Al-Isra. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْرُوحِ قُلْ الْرُوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. When they ask you, Muhammad, about the soul, tell them that I don't know anything about the soul. It is just related to Allah. It is belong to Allah. He knows the secrets of the soul, how Allah created, where the soul is. Allah knows exactly what is the significance of the soul. So that was the third question that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cannot answer, cannot tell the details about the soul. Then they got the answer. Some of them accepted Islam and some of them insist to believe in the idols and to worship the idols. But here is the point. Inshallah, during the next coming Jumu'ahs, inshallah, we are going to talk about the four stories of Surah Al-Kahf. What are the significance of Surah of these stories? What are the benefits? What is the meaning of the trials, the tribulations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to tell us, to teach us from Surah Al-Kahf? And not only this, let me share with you something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started Surah Al-Kahf. And as you know, Alhamdulillah, alladhi anzala ala abdihi al-kitaba wa lam yaj'al lahu iwaja. All praise is due to Allah. And we mentioned before, that is very important as Muslims to know what is the difference between hamd and shukr, to praise Allah and to thank Him. We mentioned that thanking or to thank Allah or to thank somebody, it is kind of exchange. He did a favor and you are thanking Him. You cannot thank anybody without doing a favor for you. I cannot come to you and say, "Brother, thank you." The first question, the first impression, "Imam, for what?" What I mean exactly. So it is kind of a change. Tit for tat, tit for tat. He did something. are praising Allah even if He did not give you anything. You are praising Allah because He is worthy of be praised. You are praising Allah for the good and bad. You are praising Allah no matter what. That is why we as Muslims, we start every rak'ah by saying, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. That is the beginning of Surah Al-Kahf. It started with Alhamdulillah Alladhi Anzala Ala Abdihi Al-Kitab. And Surah Al-Isra, the surah before Al-Kahf, and Surah Al-Kahf, the two surahs are linked together. Are linked together. Sayyidina Jibreel came with the revelation with the two surahs at one time. Surah Al-Isra and Surah Al-Kahf are linked together. And what does it mean? If you recited the last of Surah Al-Isra, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ وَسَيْ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا, that he didn't get any partner or any son. That is the last verse of Surah Al-Isra. Right after Al-Isra, you find Surah Al-Kahf. It starts with Alhamdulillah. So Allah said, at the end of Al-Isra, O Muhammad, say Alhamdulillah. Surah Al-Kahf starts by Alhamdulillah. Means that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Alhamdulillah. He praised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah. Alladhi anzala ala abdihi al-kitab. Who had been revealed the book. The book here means Al-Quran. وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ عِوَدًا. And it has no cracks. It has no, you know, fault. It has no fake news. It has no falsehood. Qayyima. Allah is describing the book of the Quran. Qayyima. It is straight. It is, you know, guide us to the straight path. That is the meaning of the beginning of the surah of Surah Al-Kahf. I just wanted to tell you something about Surah Al-Kahf. We should, as Muslims, if you didn't recite Surah Al-Kahf today, till now, still you have a chance after Jumu'ah, inshallah, to recite Surah Al-Kahf. Get the blessings. Get the reward of Surah Al-Kahf. If you cannot recite, open the Quran and listen from the YouTube, from anywhere. Listen and try to follow. Even if you cannot follow, can just I listen? Yes, you can listen. And you will be rewarded. Be aware of this, inshallah. So Surah Al-Kahf, very important. And inshallah, we are going every Jumu'ah, inshallah, to talk about one of the tribulations, one of the tests, one of the themes of Surah Al-Kahf. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all into Jannah al-Firdaws. Allahumma ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-'ali al-'azim li wa lakum. Inna alhamdulillah nahmadu ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا وسيئات اعمالنا واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك سيدي يا رسول الله. Brothers and sisters, you may ask yourselves, why I need to recite Surah Al-Kahf? Just to get the benefits? Or just to get the lessons? Or just to get some of the stories, it may make me understand life better. And not only this, you need to recite Surah Al-Kahf to get the inner peace. You need to recite Surah Al-Kahf to get the safety, the peace of mind. You need to recite Surah Al-Kahf to let the angels come to your house. And what is my evidence? My evidence is the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That hadith mentioned in Sahih Muslim that one of the Sahaba, his name is Al-Bara' ibn Azib. Al-Bara' ibn Azib. One of the companions was reciting Surah Al-Kahf. And all of a sudden, he had many horses in his house. And all of a sudden, while he is reciting, he started to find the horses are jumping, are moving very quickly. And if he stopped recitation, so the horses will stop. If he continued, the horses will start to move very quickly. And he stopped, then the horses stopped. He continued, and the horses started to move very quickly. And all of a sudden, he started to find the horses, all the horses. At the same time, they started to lead to left, or to try to, these front legs is to try to make it out. And he found kind of lights, something like chandelier. The lights started to come down to his house. The man felt that is something so strange. Lights come down, something like chandelier, and the horses are moving very strangely till he finished the recitation of Surah Al-Kahf. Then he heard to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet gave him the answer when he said, you know what? That is because you recited Surah Al-Kahf. The angels of Allah used to come down one after one, till your house was very crowded with the angels. Even the horses could not find any place to stay. And even that chandelier, even that light you saw, it is the tranquility, it is the light of the coming down of the angels. So it tells you about the importance of reciting Surah Al-Kahf. I think we as Muslims, we cannot deny all these virtues. We cannot neglect all the bounties, all the reward of reciting Surah Al-Kahf. Inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our reward, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiply our reward in reciting Surah Al-Kahf. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us all enter Jannah al-Firdaws. Allahumma ameen. Inshallah, next time we are going to talk about the story of the young men who entered to the cave. They started to escape, they started to run from the tyrant ruler in the cave. They were persecuted because of their religion, they were persecuted because of worshiping Allah. And we are going to talk about that Islam is against racism, even if that was because of the color, was of the, because of the race, because of the religion, because of the language, whatever. Islam came against the racism. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of us. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina. Allahumma tawaffana muslimin wa alhiqna bis-salihin wa ahshurna ya rabbana fi zumrat khayr al-mursalin. Allahumma tawalla amrana wa ahsin khalasana وفك أسرنا وتوفنا وأنت راض عنا. اللهم ارفع عنا البلاء، اللهم ارفع عنا البلاء، اللهم ارفع عنا البلاء، اللهم جنبنا الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن، اللهم جنبنا الأمراض، اللهم جنبنا الأمراض. Oh Allah, we ask you to protect our families, our wives, our children. Oh Allah, we ask you to protect all of us. Oh Allah, we ask you to release this pandemic. Oh Allah, we ask you. you to release that disease away from our world. Oh Allah, we ask you to grant cure and heal for everyone suffering in this world. Oh Allah, we ask you to grant all of us your mercy and to shower all of us with your mercy. Oh Allah, we ask you to forgive our sins, the minor sins and the major sins. Oh Allah, we ask you to let us all get the intercession of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة قوموا إلى صلاتكم.